Hi folks, my name is Margarita Stone, or a stoned Margarita as I was known in my past. I work at a correctional facility, and I'm the only comic in this group that has a captive audience. As a matter of fact, I'm the only comic in this group whose audience sticks around for 2 to 5 years. But man, you know, I've really changed, you know. At one point, I dealt drugs for 13 years. And the first arrest that brought me consequences was in 2001. They charged me with possession of marijuana. And they charged me with sales and distribution. Which made me feel really good. Because it made me sound way more organized than I really was. So I was put in prison. And it was the worst experience of my life. But it gave me a goal to someday work in one and make other people's lives just as miserable. So today, I work in a prison. And I work with some of the most difficult people in the world. And those are just the guards. They're always yelling, "Stop that. Pick that up, go shave, pull your pants up." And that's what they tell the women. Problem is, I work in a men's facility. I teach educational classes, life skill classes, pharmacology classes, so that the next time they go out and want to build a meth lab, they'll know how to do it right. They also have encounters. And it's where one guy confronts another guy on his negative behavior, and we referee to make sure that it doesn't break into a fight, or that if it does, that all the bets are in before they start. The confrontation involves 68 men in a dorm, an outer circle and an inner circle, 3 men that tear him down and 3 men to soothe him over. The 3 that tear him down are called streaks. The ones that soothed him over had to have been his pot dealers in the world. I'm also their disciplinarian. When they do something wrong, they step into my office and I tell them to catch a square, which is an imaginary box in the center of the room. So I not only discipline them, I have them hallucinate as well. The guards, they think the inmates can do something wrong and run to their counselors, you know, and they won't get any consequences from it. But what they don't understand is that an hour in our office with us is punishment enough. I started out selling drugs to support my husband's habit. And then I came to a crossroads and I decided I needed to make some positive changes. So I got rid of the husband and kept the clients. I delivered orders to people's houses, and I sold Avon to cover up my deliveries. But not a lot of Avon ladies carry around bongs and scales. And not a lot of Avon ladies are constantly getting the munchies. At one point, I'd take my customers' Avon samples in the same bags that I delivered their pot in. Nothing goes together better than red hair bud and purple haze eyeshadow. You know, but today, the marijuana industry, it's gotten so commercialized. Last week, I heard of someone that got a bag of pot, had the Nike logo on it, and it said, "Just do it." So he smoked the whole pound. You know, I've been married 5 times. And the last 3 were involved in my selling. I always wanted a family-run business. My 5th husband, he turned me in when he got busted. Apparently, he wanted to share everything with me, including his arrest. But really, you know, I came from a very strict upbringing. My first 2 marriages ended because I wouldn't tolerate their drug use. I figured if it was going to work, they at least had to be selling. At the peak of my business, I had several guys driving several vehicles. They were all making my deliveries. And the joke among them was that they were part of Margie's harem. That's ridiculous, though, because if I was going to pick a harem, I'd pick guys with teeth. Thanks, folks.